In our contribution on synthetic silviculture, we present a novel multi-scale approach to design realistically modeled large-scale plant ecosystems that faithfully capture biological features such as growth, plant interactions, different types of tropism, and the competition for resources. We introduce temperature and precipitation as an effortless means of control for modeling the diversity of different ecosystems. While temperature defines the overall fertility and diversity of plant types, variations in precipitation are responsible for the density of biomass. The two-dimensional temperature-precipitation space allows for characterizing the main types of plant ecosystems: desert, tundra, savanna, grassland, shrubland, boreal forest, temperate seasonal and rainforest, as well as tropical seasonal and rainforest. Our approach is able to appropriately grow all these 9 distinct plant ecologies shown in the temperature-precipitation diagram. It is further able to capture transitions and interpolations between them. We provide a library defining plant type-specific parameters. For advanced use, these parameters can also be modified by the user. Here, we exemplary demonstrate how changing the maximum vigor influences the plant's development. Now, we demonstrate the influence of changing the direction of gravitropism. In order to grow a specific plant ecosystem, the user can specify a seeding radius within the temperature precipitation space for each plant type. This is used to define in which biome the individual plant types will grow. After the parameters for all plant types have been set, the user can proceed to the simulation tab. The system will automatically select the correct plant types for a corresponding biome and grow each plant depending on the available resources. Once a satisfactory result has been achieved, the branch modules and their individual transformations, along with metadata for connectivity, branch diameter, plant type, and leaf flag can be exported. This allows for further use and post-processing, such as an easy rendering of the scene in any off-the-shelf rendering software. Here, a 400 years simulation of a pine tree forest is shown. First, the ecosystem patch is dominated by fast-growing shrubs. After a couple of decades, the pine trees grow large enough to overshadow the shrubs, thus reducing the available light until the undergrowth dies off completely. The pine trees continue to grow and reduce the available light in the lower part of the forest. Please note how individual modules are pruned from the pine trees due to insufficient amount of vigor. Finally, the more shadow-resistant spruce trees overgrow the previously dominating pine trees. For more artistic control, we allow the user to remove certain trees from the simulation. Our model faithfully captures the response of the remaining ecosystem. Here, we remove some of the ecosystem's dominant plant type. The disturbance allows faster-growing plant types to take advantage of the now available light, and as such, we see palm trees temporarily taking over the subregion of the ecosystem until the previously dominating plant types once again overshadows this region. Our framework allows for the handling of external objects within the system. In this scene, the trees are reacting appropriately by adapting their growing process according to the structure of the house. Our approach allows to interactively grow and render large forest scenes of several hundreds of thousand tree models within our framework. Each tree model is represented by its own surface mesh. New trees grow, interact with their neighbors, and eventually die. As a final scene, we simulate the temporal evaluation of a complex plant ecosystem in an initially empty mountainous region over a couple of hundred years. The elevation varies by about 250 meters. We consider 3 different plant types: shrubs, conifers, and deciduous trees. Their seeds are assumed to be distributed almost uniformly within the region. Such a setup can, for example, occur after glaciers were largely melted at the end of an ice age. As in the case of the pine tree forest, the ecosystem is dominated by fast-growing shrubs after a couple of decades. Since the conifers are growing significantly slower, it takes some time until they overshadow the shrubs, thus reducing the available light until the less shade-tolerant shrubs in the undergrowth die off. Finally, the even slower growing and more shadow-resistant deciduous trees overgrow the previously dominating conifers, establishing themselves as the dominant plant type in the lower regions. Due to the different temperature resilience, one can observe a segregation of dominant plant types on different elevation levels. The deciduous trees are the primary plant type in lower regions, whereas the shrubs are dominating in higher regions, and conifers are mostly present in between. These results mirror common natural landscapes as well as their evolution processes. Thank you for your interest in our work and watching this video.